negative cultural gender norms and beliefs towards the consumption of nutrient-dense and health diets have been identified as key contributors towards malnutrition. Stunting and anemia have over the time had long-term consequences on individuals and society, which among others include poor educational performance, lost productivity, an increased risk of nutrition-related chronic diseases in adult life.
Culturally, there is a belief that women are not supposed to eat chicken, they're not supposed to eat eggs, they're not supposed to eat fish, they're not supposed to eat some parts of the chicken or some animals, and of which I think those things, all of them, are nutritious.
I have seen that these are eaten by women and these are not eaten by women. So like women usually not eat fish, chicken, eggs and other things. But now we want to adapt according to the science. There is nothing wrong with eating with those things. That's why our children maybe are lacking these things in their bodies.
Our cultural beliefs, you women are not supposed to eat eggs, women are not supposed to eat grasshoppers, etc. But we are missing a lot. We should note that these products are very nutritious.
Because of some cultural aspects that we have found out that according to the nutrition, it has nothing to do with culture. It is only boosting and improving on the diet of a baby, unborn baby, and the mother to be strong. So we have found out that we should adopt and we should change our mindset.
During the Toro Kingdom Dialogue on Nutrition that was organized by Care Uganda in Food Portal today, it was noted that consumption of health diets and production of diverse foods is key towards building blocks for optimal nutrition status and a core element of food and nutrition security.
That is why we are now engaging you, the community structures here, the cultural institutions, the religious institutions, to better understand what norms are existing. For norms and malnutrition, there's a very strong linkage between the two, and we cannot do without them because society is who we are. Society is where we belong.
Bernard Kule, a nutritionist in the region, has explained how Toro continues to register high levels of malnutrition despite it being regarded as a food basket. To address the existing challenge, Kule says that a lot of civic education needs to be done.
But the reality is, the region is not deficient of food. The region actually has food. The region even has healthy food available in some parts. The only challenge is that we have a number of other risk factors that are contributing to this challenge, which actually are not yet very much noticed and probably supported enough by the actors or by the different stakeholders. When you look at our region, people do not know about what to eat, even when they have it, but people do not know, why do I eat what? When can I eat what? What is the quality of the meal and what is the quantity of the meal? So in terms of household consumption patterns, we still have a challenge that even when people have a lot of food, but the food is monotonous. People have mono diets every single time someone is eating banana or something like that.
Story compiled by Roger Sunday for the News in Food Portal.